Hi everybody, Corinne Blackstone here. Welcome to my computer, I guess. We are going to do a really quick tutorial on the brand new Cricut Guides. This is something that Cricut has added to Design Space, so we're going to check them out. I'll show you a little bit about them, that way you guys understand how to use them and what the purpose is. Now before we get started, be sure to subscribe to my channel, that way you don't miss out on any of the crafty content that we have here. So without further ado, let's check out how to use the Cricut Guides. Whatever we would do, we do it just for fun. Here in Cricut Design Space, they've added a new feature called Guides, and a lot of people have asked me, what are they? What's the purpose of them? So I thought I'd show you just a real quick tutorial over what the guides are and ways that I would personally use them. So let's start and say that we're going to make a wood round. What I would do is open up a shape, and I've shown you guys templates before, and that's basically what guides are with a few little differences. So let's say that I have a 10-inch square, or a 10-inch circle, I should say, and that's where I want to put my design, is onto a 10-inch circle. Now, typically when I do this, I'm going to go ahead and select an image. And I'm just gonna pick kind of whatever. I just use this Daddy's Grilling Plate one is fine. And I'm gonna add that to my canvas. Now I've shown you how to use templates before. We make the size and we design it and then figure out how big we can make our design based on the size of the image and our background and things like that. But when we go to click make it, we have to hide our template. Using guides, you won't have to do that. What you'll want to do to turn on a guide, which is basically just a template, is to select the shape that you want to use for your template, and under operations, change it over here on the very bottom to guide. You'll see that it becomes a transparent circle with a pink outline. Now when I go to click make it, it's only going to bring up my mat with my image. So I don't actually have to hide the template. It's just there to help me guide what size I need to use. Now, another cool thing that you can do with the guides is, let's say that we've already cut this out, but we really didn't like the look of what's in the center of our design. But we do want to have something instead of the fork and the knife and the spatula. We'd like to use maybe something different. So what you can do is change your image to guide as well. And then just like when you do other things, you can use contour with the guides. So I'm going to contour out the little cutlery in the center by just selecting those pieces. And I want to make sure I get rid of the little slots on my spatula. And now you'll see your guide doesn't have that middle portion, but you won't have to cut out your image again, if that makes sense. And I'm just going to choose another image to place in the center. And that is going to be this little fire. I don't know. I'm just choosing shapes and images just to make this easy to explain to you. That way we can size down our little campfire to fit within our design. And now when we go to click make it, we know that this is going to fit in our design, but rather than having to hide the original design and things like that, all we have is our campfire instead of having to go through that whole process of like hiding it or deleting it. Now let me show you how to use it with print and cut, because I think that's going to be super handy as well. So you know, typically when we do print and cut projects, we always want to use a template so that we can fit as much space and stickers as we can within our print and cut area. So I'm going to open up a square, and like always, I'm going to unlock it. And because we're using 8.5 by 11 paper, we can cut 6.75 wide by 9.25 high. Now I'm going to change this to a guide, and that way it won't print. I don't have to hide it. I don't have to do anything for it. And I can always just save this and use this section for when I make print and cut stickers. So let's go ahead and add some images to this. And what I love is that you can kind of choose over here the operation types. You can just choose print and cut, and then you can pick a couple of different designs. Let's just go with these flowers. We'll just pick a couple of them and click add to canvas. And then just like you would if you were just using that gray square to size them and to fit them into your area, you can now do this with just using this template guide. This is great for sizing for all sorts of things, whether you're doing signs, shirts, whatever it may be. This is an excellent way to size your designs. So I'm just going to go ahead and size my stickers down a bit. I'm not really trying to like be super careful about where I stick these, other than that I just want them in the square here. So I'm just going to fit a bunch of them in here however I can. Again, really not trying to squeeze a ton in, but you get the general idea. So I'm going to go ahead and duplicate a flower and just put it down here. We'll duplicate it again. I'm just going to fill this page so that you guys can get an idea of how this little guide template is going to work for print and cut. So just duplicate this guy. All right, that looks pretty good. We've filled up quite a bit of our space here. So now, instead of having to hide that square or delete that square so that I can attach everything, I can just select the entire design and simply click attach. It won't attach the guide. It'll only attach what you're trying to cut, and that way it's not going to cut out the guide. I hope that makes sense. Now it is telling me that it's a little bit too big. I can see that I have one of my little squares just a little too far out, so I'll size it down just a hair. But now again, you can see we still have that pink square. But now when we click make it, that pink square will not be there. You'll see here that our stickers are all set, ready to go without that additional square. So really, guides are just a way for you to use templates of any shape or size that you want to without using a Cricut template, because sometimes those can be a little bit off-sized. They can be a little bit limiting. And in this case, you can make it whatever size or shape that you want to. You can also template your own designs and images as well. So I hope that helps you guys understand how to use the Cricut guides. If you have any questions, let me know in those comments down below. I would love to hear from you guys. I hope you all have a wonderful day, and as always, happy crafting!